National Football League. And the spotlight is on Nick Chubb. He was an unstoppable force last week with well over 200 yards. It's the Browns and the Cardinals, and it's coming up next.
From just off the shores of Lake Erie, EA Sports brings you coverage of the NFL from Cleveland Browns Stadium in downtown Cleveland, Ohio. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup. We're all set to go as it will be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Cleveland Browns.
Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we look at this Browns ball club. They've certainly found their groove of late, winners of five in a row.
And I think the sky's the limit for this team. They're playing the best football that they've played in a long time.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Cardinals here, they were losers their last time out. They're going to try to get back in the win column, but obviously they're going to have to do that in a hostile environment.
And sometimes it actually works to your advantage. Now,
so the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
But you look at this defense. They're right around the middle of the pack, number 15 in the NFL against the run.
I jotted down in my notes in prepping for this game that this is definitely an area we got to keep an eye on, because you're talking about where they rank in stopping the run. Well, how about what they're facing? This unit loves to run the football, and they rank highly in the league.
And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Carlos Watkins busting through to get him for a loss of six. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And pressure coming, and they got him once again.
B.J. Ogilari getting in there and dropping him.
The Browns send out their punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of five. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Here's James Conner now as he trots back on. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They begin this drive with Chubb. Shoves him away. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven, past the 30 to the 32. A check on the numbers for Chubb from a week ago. There was no answer for him defensively. Over 200 yards, two touchdowns to boot.
And that was a fun film to watch, because a few of those runs, it was apparent he was just not going to be denied. And his team is hoping that that carries over to this week as well.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
One thing you always worry about when he breaks the pocket is he going to take off with it? That time, the pressure was starting to close in, and he's just got to throw this one away.
Eluding the pressure right. And he fires one, but incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line. So a change of possession here on... The Browns drive about to get started.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here, because now you're down three scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession, but I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a four-score deficit. And if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
Under pressure now, Watson, and down he goes.
Loss of 10 as multiple defenders get to him.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Watson's throw taken in by Cooper here.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
That is caught, and he is going to have a Browns first down, and he was able to get it by plenty, a gain of 8 on third and 3.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Chubb on the counter. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Watson gets this one to Cooper.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 21. Watson now to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
So it looks like they stopped some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Now Watson will step away, and out comes Cade York to handle this fourth down field goal try for the Browns. York able to send this one through. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room down 21-10 as opposed to 21-3. 21-10, a little more optimism, a little more bounce around the locker room, a little more discussion about how they're going to finish this thing off. 21-3, I think discouragement clouds that locker room.
Yeah, and I think a touchdown much bigger than a field goal on this drive. Here's a diving catch right side. A big play that time for Cleveland. And even 40 yards. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Watson.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 27-yard line. Touchdown, Browns! David Njoku, his third touchdown now on the air. And the Browns are able to make some inroads. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Now a play fake, and it's Watson. They'll roll him out right. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
And he is such a tough quarterback to defend because you got to remember, arguably, He's more dangerous outside the pocket than he is in it. But how about the job they did defensively to stay with the receiver and knock the ball away? I think they had a sigh of relief there because...
Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. Inside the 10. And they bring this one back. A scoop and score. A fumble recovery touchdown for Arizona. Huge, huge play by the defense. Not only to... The Browns drive about to get started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. That's complete to Peoples-Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Halftime over, no problem with us. We skip right to the third quarter and continue this midseason contest. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
Donovan Peoples-Jones now from the end zone.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The offense trots back out there. Let's turn our focus. The third quarter starts with a run by Chubb. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Second down, here's Chubb again.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. And now they're in the hurry up. Now a first down throw, Watson. Now a diving effort right sideline. He's got it. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. Now Watson. And incomplete on the deep ball.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone. That they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 16.
Well, hang on now. We're going to pause here. We've got an injured player. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside.
Now Chubb running right. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18.
That's Zaven Collins into the backfield with ease and making the stick.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first.
Throwing on third down, Watson flush to his right. And Njoku pulls this one in. He's got it for a Cleveland touchdown. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Watson on first down. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Now a throw here going to be taken in by the tight end Njoku. It'll go as a gain of 4. Second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And no timeout.
A give running right is Chubb. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
I think the defenders have to feel pretty good. Even though the ball was tipped in the air and could have become a big play for the offense, they actually won one because the guy flinging it today, he's having quite the performance. A couple of touchdown passes, almost threw his first interception, but he's throwing it so well that I think Lady Luck was on his side.
Deshaun Watson, so multi-dimensional, able to scramble for the first.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there because, to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's Watson. And that's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. To throw is Watson. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Browns are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. Not the 1st and goal play they drew up. Multiple defenders in to bring him down to the ground. Back to throw, Watson. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Watson and that Browns offense going to stay out there, and they'll go for 2. They'll try and throw for it, and he's got it for the 2-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. On 1st down, Watson. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment.
From the 50, it's Watson. And that is taken in by Njoku. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. On first and 10, Watson. Flushed out right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Here's second and 10.
Watson looks to throw again. The pass caught by his running back, Nick Chubb. Touchdown! Now for the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it's capped off by the Browns' touchdown. And a touchback as Dortch elects not to return it. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over.
And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all 3 timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the 2-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
He'll get this up to the 47 and brought down there.
Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7.
He's going to get it again, just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. They'll try and run forward with Connor. Now the Browns signal for the 2nd of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
On is the punter, Hawk, as he gets this one away.
And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the... To throw, Watson, escaping the pressure right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. This defense hasn't had the best showing in this game, but a critical knockdown there. If they can hang on, I guess the end will kind of justify the means.
Certainly, and just think of it this way. It may not be the quantity of the plays that they've had, because those haven't been great, but they get a few more quality ones like that, that could finish things off for them.
And he'll be wrangled to the ground right there at the 32-yard line. This is where, of course, it's good to have a veteran quarterback under center.
You would just be able to put on one of those blood pressure clips, and nothing would be different for him. He's done it many times before, expects to get it accomplished again.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get separate plays off in quick succession if they can.
And this pass broken up. Now the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
With that incompletion, reality is staring them right in the face. This entire game is down to the next snap.
Desperation time. Watson on fourth down. That is caught. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, this offense still has the 1 timeout here, remember. 1st and 10.
Throw left side, caught by the tight end, Njoku. The Browns will quickly use their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the 4th.
Here's 1st and 10.
Now Watson. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Here's Watson. Going out wide, finds Chubb. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Charles, they're trying to protect this lead late. Those are the types of mistakes they could afford to go without.
About the last thing you want to give them is help in completing a comeback, which is exactly what that penalty does.
Now first and goal. Watson. And his ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now the final seconds are PAT away from Lake. Now the decision is to go for two. A gutsy call, and this, in effect, is your ball game right here. And it is caught. They got the 2 points, and with it, they've taken the lead. And boy, you want... The Browns kicking team out there now as they'll send this one away. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
So for Cleveland, the victory moves him to 7-1 on the year. And
It's the NFL on EA Sports. And up next, we'll see Aaron Jones. He really helped drive them a week ago with a 3-touchdown game. It's the Packers and the Rams, coming up next.
There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup. We are all set to go as it'll be the Los Angeles Rams taking on the Green Bay Packers. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it 2 in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Rams, they come off a disappointment last time out that put an end to their modest 3-game win streak. Nothing on the scoreboard, 0-0, as the offense gets ready to take over the football. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he powers through the first wave, but he's going to be swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On third down, Love. And that will be incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. That's taken it around the 40. A 41-yard punt, 9 on the return, and the Rams will go on offense here with the 1st and 10.
So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. Right now, we're all even. It's a tie game as we drop you back in and the offense gets set to take over. Love, they go play action now. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and is pumped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there and it's second and 11. Love now. That's complete to Wicks. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 36. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On play action. Love to throw. Rolling to his left. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. Love going to give this one to Jones. And some strong running there as he's down just shy of the 20 on the edge of the red zone. Now, during that run, an injury here. We got one of those big blockers in some discomfort. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. The Packers now at 2-5 to start play. Now they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home.
And it's a Packers touchdown. Jaden Reed, his second touchdown on the season. And the Packers will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense. But when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
Love's throw pulled in by Melton. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll try the right side with Jones. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. Play three of the drive not as successful. They go backwards after those two first down gains. Here's Jones again on second down. And he's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage, but that's about it. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. Third down and 10. Here's Love. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 33. Play action this time with Love. And he rifles one incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion.
Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Now a second and 10.
They go back to the ground with Jones. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
41 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Play fake. Here's Love. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. With a little over 2 minutes to play in the second quarter, the offense gets ready to take over. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And bulldozing his way through.
And he will be out of bounds. A good yardage there, and he'll get a second to catch his breath as it leads us right into the two-minute warning.
First down, Love to pass. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. To throw now, here's Love. He'll find Jones again, complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 7 yards there and a first down. Love. His throw incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Going back to Love. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Throwing. Love. He finds his man. Complete. It's Reed. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Love looking to throw it. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Love now on second down. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
They'll complete this one to Watson.
That pass play good for 7, but it still brings up a fourth and goal. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And this one is right through. And that will extend their lead here to 17-6. So this offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Off the play fake, Love. Eluding the pressure right, and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. Now Love. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 41. Now the throw, and I think the ball's out, but this will get out of bounds. down, so possession will stay the same.
Could almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture.
72 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
To pass, here's Jordan Love. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Touchdown, Packers! Jaden...
It'll be a first and 10 coming up as this offense takes over possession of the football in the third quarter.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
And from the 34, here's second and 4.
Again, it's Jones. And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They're able to convert with a gain of 4. Switching things up, they'll throw it now with Jordan Love. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. It's a gain of 34. First down, going to the air with Love. And Watson has it right side. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Jones will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2.
Give him 3 on the gain there. Second and goal.
Jones again.
And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown.
Aaron Jones.
Third quarter action. This offense will have a first and 10 as they get set for the next drive.
Love now to pass on first down.
And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
Green Bay, Wisconsin is the spot. Third quarter inside Lambeau. Glad you're with us. Second and 10. Off play action. Love.
Oh, a first mistake for him in the ball game as it's intercepted.
Picked off by John Johnson.
And the Rams are going to take over a couple of yards shy.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
And, Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right?
Right.
The best teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now.
Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Second down, Love. He finds his man, complete. That's Reed. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Running right, Jones. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That really sets them back. A loss of 6. Tough spot looking at 2nd and 16 here after the big loss. They'll go again to Jones. And this one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just a yard.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up 4th. They'll go with Jones. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. He's been tough. So it's all over. A Green Bay victory.
It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports, and the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Buccaneers and the Texans, and it's all up next.
On a wonderful fall afternoon in the state of Texas, the roof is open. So this offense will head back out there. Already an excellent field position. They run here with Singletary. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A good run of 6 yards there gets him closer to the goal line with 2nd down coming up.
That's good hard running right there on 1st and goal. That gets him down to the 2 and puts a lot more pressure on that defense.
Stroud now on 2nd down. Forced out to his left. And he just chopped that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
Boy, that was lockdown coverage there. He's scanning for someone to come open. But that was great work to blanket everyone. And in the end, he's just got to throw it away.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. On the ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And down he goes. throws a Buccaneer sack. Vita Vea, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. And they'll go play action here with Stroud. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And that is how you respond after taking one on the chin to begin this game. Give up a first drive touchdown, go back out on defense, and completely shut them down to force a 3-and-out.
Returnable here from the 38. And they can't bring him down. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the Buccaneer offense. This offense ready to head back out there as they'll take over with a little over a minute to play in this first quarter. Singletary to get the drive started. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Clock runs, less than a minute to go, and an entertaining first quarter of play. On first down, here's Stroud. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, 22. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing now is Stroud. He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's second down. 7-7, our score after one. Ready for the second quarter from Houston. It's the Texans in possession of the football. Ball on the 36 now. Here's second and 5. Pierce gets this one running right. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Now we're going to get a timeout. Appears we've got an injured Buccaneer. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Stroud to throw it. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed 1 conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it, and he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. First and 10, it's Pierce. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. The Texans now at 2-5 to start play. Now they were losers last time out, trying to turn things around here in this one.
And it always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement as long as you give them something good to cheer about. So you know they just want to come out and play well for their faithful, and I expect them to do just that.
A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. Stroud on third down now. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the box 19. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Stroud now on first and 10. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. On second down, here's Pierce. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Stroud.
Swings this one out wide for Pierce.
And he'll be brought down shy of the first down marker at the 11. That'll give him 8 that time. And it'll be fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
Stroud now on fourth down.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Woods.
And the Texans are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They'll run here with Pierce.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. He'll get 6 on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up.
Stroud, he's going to audible to something else.
Second and 1. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. So they'll wind up losing 5 yards on the play. And now we've got a third and goal situation.
Third and goal, Stroud.
Flush to his right. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
Well, your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Flushed out right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
I tell you what, that's a veteran play from a guy in his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to force something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
He's got his target. That's complete.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. It goes as a gain of 6, and it's a first down.
And Stroud now to throw. Catch is made. It's Schultz on the out route.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Stroud off the play fake.
And his throw here is incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Meanwhile, Stroud's throw complete here to his receiver, Brown.
Now the Texans will use one of their 2 remaining timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Now they'll throw it with Stroud here, 1st and 10.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Robert. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter.
A run by Pierce begins the second half.
And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's 2nd and 9 from the 26.
Right. And Pierce gets it again on second down.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line.
Tough spot here, third down and 11. Stroud looking to throw. That is caught, and he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Hand off right side to Pierce to about the 40-yard line.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And now it's 3rd and 3.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Now here's Stroud on 3rd down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6.
They'll bring a tight end in motion left.
Back to the ground with Pierce.
Puts it on the carpet. It's out.
Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
And they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard.
And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. On 2nd down, it's Stroud. That's complete to Dell.
Now we're going to get a timeout. Here's we've got an injured Buccaneer.
Hopefully, obviously nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. 1st and 10, it's Stroud. That is incomplete.
That's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up, converged on his man, and broke the play up.
Now a handoff for Pierce.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
But backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Now Stroud.
Escaping the pressure right. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. That'll bring up 4th down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that. The kick by Fairbairn is good, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with 3 and increase that lead.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they've got the lead here getting late into the 3rd quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that, but the rushing game almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off, they need the running game to come back to life. They need to get sparked that way, take some time off the clock, and keep the ball away from their opponents.
So that run play nullified by the holding call on the tight end.
Yeah, I just think he needs to get off the ball a lot quicker and get into the block a little bit more effectively. Then he doesn't have to reach and grab and try and hold on.
Give to Pierce. And the defense on him quickly there as they stop him at the 40 for a gain of just 2.
Final minute now of the 3rd quarter.
And Pierce gets it again on 2nd down.
And he's got some space here.
On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40.
That good for 19 and a 1st down.
Stroud will run the option left.
And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. 3 quarters in the books.
You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Back now in Houston. It's the Texans in control of the football and leading this game as well as we start the fourth.
On the bootleg, Stroud.
This is caught. It's Woods. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Big one there for the Texans, 18 yards.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Toss play. Here's Pierce.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Singletary here running out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here.
This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. Touchdown, Texans! Late stages of the game here in the fourth quarter as this offense takes over 1st and 10.
Give left side for Pierce.
It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Stroud sets up the play action.
Eluding the pressure right. This is caught. Touchdown.
Take down.
His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Texans. But Charles, you think about this victory.
Thank you.
It's Madden NFL.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play.
Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. On first down, Carr. There's Chris Olave. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A Saints first down there on a gain of 11. On play action, now Carr. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
The Saints at 500 now, 4-4 on the year. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down. Carr gonna throw. That's complete to Marone, the tight end. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Carr. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New York. They start the drive on the ground, Kamara. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. The numbers there for Kamara from a week ago. 18 carries, 83 yards.
After the last game, they have plenty of reason to be confident in their running game. And even though they're facing a top-10 defense, they're not going to shy away from doing what they do best. Make them adjust to them. Make them stop what they do before they go.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, New Orleans! Juwan Jackson. Carr now on first down. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line.
Nice job by the defense figuring that play out and holding it to a short game, but I don't think the offense is going to be daunted. They actually accomplished their goal there. Now they've got them aware that they can throw a screen at them, maybe to slow the pass rush down a little bit, and they can throw it downfield.
And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 7 yards there and a first down. They stay on the ground. This time it's Williams. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Now Carr. Throw right side into the hands of Foster Moreau. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Into the red zone. It's Carr. That's complete right around the 8. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His 2nd catch in a row, 1st down. Kamara is in. Touchdown, New Orleans. So throwing on 1st down is Carr. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Carr out of throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on 3rd down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Blake Gillikin on to punt now on 4th down. It's a 39-yard punt, 3 on the return, and the Bears take over. The Chicago offense set. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So it's halftime here. It passed the halfway point of the season and now past the halfway point of this game. We skip halftime and get right back to the action. Set to begin the 3rd quarter. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. Set now to go for the 3rd quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. So here are the Saints to take over. They've won 2 straight and they lead this one as well as they come. They start the 2nd half with Kamara. And he'll get this up just shy of the 30.
Nice chunk of yards on 1st down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on 2nd. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
And he'll find Moreau here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 75 yards receiving for him now. It's a 1st down. Here's Carr. Catch made. It's Moreau. And he's brought down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. Now a play fake. Carr. And this is taken in at the 5. Touchdown, Saints. On play action, it's Carr. And that's caught. It's Brian Edwards. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 32 on the play. Kamara up the middle. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Throwing his car on 3rd down. That is caught and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Now following the completion, we're going to get a stoppage here for an injury. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
And not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
So after four touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time at four.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Working from the gun, it's Carr.
He'll get this one underneath to Kamara.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And it'll be second down. Carr. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, New Orleans. Third touchdown pass now for Derek Carr. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. Whistles now and a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the two-minute warning.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down.
And he's going to take this one down to the 25. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. So no shortage of offense in this game.
And the drive starts with a carry by Stevenson.
And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. How about Jonathan Allen there, pushing upfield to make the stop behind the line? Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
You talk about this Washington defense.
They've been pretty good against the pass. Not amazing, but good. Number 13 in the league.
And since this is such a good unit of covering passes downfield, I think that last play is typical of what we might see. A lot of short passes, see if they can generate some run after the catch. But nothing doing on that one.
Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10.
Up the middle, here's Stevenson. And he'll work down inside the 45. Now the rushing numbers for Stevenson from last week.
12 carries, 70 yards.
They've lost a bunch of games in a row now. They've got to start thinking a little bit differently, maybe a little bit outside of the box. Find other ways to move the football. I don't know if you're going to do it through the air or maybe change up how you establish your run game.
And Parker's going to pick up a Patriots first down as he'll get this down to the 35-yard line.
Throwing, Jones. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The Patriots at 1-7 now on the year. Yeah, they've lost three straight here, and it kind of goes without saying, I guess, but they could certainly use a win.
Yeah, no doubt about that. There's a difference between a losing stretch and a losing streak, and right now, they're not playing their best football, but if they were to fall here, and now you're looking at going four games without a win, things can start compounding themselves pretty quickly from this point forward.
And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And his kick is absolutely perfect, and that'll do it. Start of the second quarter from Foxborough. It's the homestanding Patriots with the football as they get set to start their drive with a first and 10. And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. They run once more with Stevenson. Shoves him aside. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking. And that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Now Jones.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long. And that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
They'll try the left side with Stevenson.
And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third.
And this one dropped in the end zone. Oh, looked like a touchdown, but not to be. And now it's fourth down.
And his kick here is good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6.
So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer.
A quick pass out to Juju. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Back to throw. Jones. That's taken in by Ferkser. And he'll be wrangled to the ground right there at the 32-yard line. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
They'll work from the 36 on 2nd and 6.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And his throw is incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And the Commanders will take over with a 1st and 10.
On 1st down, Jones.
He finds Parker.
Now the Patriots will use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. From the 40 now on 2nd down, Jones.
And this one too low.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on 3rd down.
Pass taken in by his big tight end.
The Patriots will take their 3rd and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line.
They'll look to throw again. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Picked off by Cameron Curl. And the Commanders are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
And as we've seen, points have been precious so far, and they just threw some away on that snap. And look, let's face it, as we advance further into this game,
they'll run with Stevenson to begin the drive.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Anthony Barr in on the tackle. Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Off the play fake. Jones.
Pass on the out route caught by Smith-Schuster.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Stevenson now on 1st and 10. And a lane slow and materializing there as he'll get maybe a yard up to the 45.
What an advantage having an elite guy in the middle of the defensive line, because not only does he take up the space and let the linebackers run free, but he can also make plays himself, as we just saw there.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week, he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week, he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense, they spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it, and that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. And they'll get to this and down it inside the 25 at the 24-yard line. So here is Washington now to take over. They've dropped. They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. A give for Stevenson, running right. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. The Commanders bringing out the nickel package on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Quan Martin. Fighting his way through contact. And he will bring this one back. An intercept. Jones, another shot here after the pick six. And he whips that one incomplete there. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that. And thus far, they've been successful.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Washington on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. Here it's third and two. That's complete. Once again, it's Gesicki. And he will have a Patriots first down as they get 5 there on third and two.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Straight ahead at Stevenson. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
They have 3 tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Again, it's Stevenson. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 39. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. To the right side, this is Stevenson. There's a nice move. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Running left is Stevenson. And he's down into the red zone at the 16 after a gain of 16. First and 10.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the
And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Mike Gesicki, his second touchdown on the season. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll try and throw for it, and he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the fourth. Still time to work. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
They suspected it. It was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 14 yards is the pickup there and a New England first down. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he carries this one past the midfield stripe and into Commander territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Over the middle, hauled in by Smith-Schuster. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 24-yard line. All 3 timeouts plus the 2-minute warning. Here's 1st and 10. Now a handoff, Stevenson. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a score to break this tie. 2nd and 6 coming up. On 2nd down, Elliott. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as they stop it here with 1:07 remaining.
Plenty of time. All 3 timeouts still remain. Here's 1st and 10 now.
A 1st down carry by Elliott. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now Washington going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
And now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they get the stoppage with just over 1 minute to go in the game. And he'll take this one down near the 15.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Kick is good, and the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. So there was a little meetup.
Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away.
And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. This is first and 10.
Powell to throw.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
And a fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the...
It's week 9 of the NFL, and we'll see Geno Smith. Solid performance a week ago, throwing for 3 touchdowns. It's the Seahawks and the Ravens, and it comes your way next on EA Sports.
With Chesapeake Bay gleaming in the distance, we are inside M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup. We are all set to go, as it'll be the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Baltimore Ravens.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Raven team as they get ready here. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of 4 of their last 6 games. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Seahawks, whatever promise they had to start the season fully evaporated now as they come in losers of 6 straight.
And sometimes when you're in the middle of a losing streak, being on the road is exactly what you want. You can only depend on each other. Let's see if they can use that as fuel in this ball game.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. The drive starts with a carry by Edwards. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. A look at the numbers last week for Edwards. 15 carries, 58 yards.
They've lost a bunch of games in a row now. They've got to start thinking a little bit differently, maybe a little bit outside of the box. Find other ways to move the football. I don't know if you're going to do it through the air or maybe change up how you establish your run game.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver, and it's third and four.
You talk about this Seahawk defense.
It's quite a unit, number one in the NFL against the pass.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top five.
Now it's Lockett. 42-yard punt, six on the return. And it'll be Seahawk. So second quarter, this offense losing and hoping to get the football in the end zone for the first time. Throwing now, Jackson on first down.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
On third down, Jackson. And this one is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
Fourth down, and out comes Jordan Stout here to punt.
44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Returnable for Lockett. It's a return of five following a punt of 42 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over.
There's Tyler Lockett and the rest of his Seattle teammates coming out for the next.
So this offense will head back out there, already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. They'll start out here with the option left. The quick feet by Jackson. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. Now it's Jackson. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Now Lamar changing the look. Accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
A good down to possibly take a shot, and in fact, they'll come up with an empty backfield on second and inches. Now Jackson. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And he'll get this down inside the five to the four before he's out of bounds. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Edwards.
And he will force his way into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown.
Gus Edwards, his third rushing touchdown.
All right, the offense back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play.
Now Jackson on first down. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
Play action. Now Jackson.
And this is into the hands of Andrews downfield.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down.
They run with Edwards off the option.
And he stopped immediately there.
Kobe Bryant makes the stop on that one.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score.
Second and 10.
From the gun, Jackson.
He finds Bateman over the middle.
He won't find a ton of space following the display of power as he's down just inside the 45. And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Jackson now. And he is caught. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. To throw is Jackson. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. So we've come upon halftime with a visiting seat.
Halftime over, no problem with us. We skip right to the third quarter and continue this midseason contest.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon.
A field goal the difference. 17-14 is the score. Back underway here now in this third quarter.
The Raven offense set to...
They go play action now. Jackson.
And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete.
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with a short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Throwing is Jackson. And got his man complete. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. A gain of 32 that time. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
Jackson on the give to Dobbins.
And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Jamal Adams coming up from his safety spot to make the play.
Second and 9.
Jackson. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had it and dropped it.
That is an unforced error there, and it takes away what could have been a touchdown.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. It's a 9-yard gain, and it'll keep the drive moving. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
They go back to the ground with Dobbins. And he'll get this just inside the 30-yard line. From the 29, here's second down and 7.
Play action. It's Jackson. And in for the Ravens touchdown.
Isaiah Likely.
His third touchdown now on the year. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Jackson on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, the great coach has said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
I thought at first he'd try to run, but he just kept buying time to his right. Finally, nothing there. He wisely gets rid of it.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Taken from just outside the 30.
So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And they will take over first and 10.
So here are the Seahawks ready to... They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Now Dobbins again on second down.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Here's Jackson to throw. Completes it to Aguilar.
Ran the perfect defense in this situation. Would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
The gain there of 21 yards. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 32-yard line. They go play action with Jackson.
Throwing out left and finding Likely.
And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Jackson. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore.
Isaiah Likely.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Here's Jackson.
Flush to his right.
And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
It's been a nice day for him as a passer and as a runner. One of the few mistakes he's made in this ballgame. The wrong choice on that one. That one goes incomplete.
They'll try again here. Second and 10. Now Jackson. Connecting with Andrews. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding where they are in the field?
Jackson to throw. That is caught, Bateman.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Throwing, Jackson. Looking for Bateman, he's got him complete.
Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And this is going to be pulled in by the tight end, Andrews. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two.
Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
What an outstanding drive right there to take the lead. And all.
And that will make this a four-point game. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in seven plays.
And it's capped off by the late touchdown that puts him out in front here in the final minute of the contest. Coming out of the end zone, D. Eskridge. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. So Geno and the Seahawks.
Down 35-31, 23 seconds to go. Now their losing streak in danger of continuing as they come up on first down. And that one drops to the ground, incomplete. Clock stops here just inside of 20 seconds, 19 left.
Smith. Throw out wide to Walker.
Oh, and what a nice tackle there. That will hardly move the needle at all offensively. A very short game.
Here's Smith.
Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it. And that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the two-minute drill. The offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that...
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left.
That was an excellent come from behind.
It's Madden NFL 24, and we'll see Bryce Young. There were plenty of highlights for him in last week's game, nearly 500 yards through the air. It's the Panthers and the Colts, and it kicks off next on Madden NFL 24.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup. We are all set to go as it'll be the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Carolina Panthers.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories.
And the offense, my goodness, over 50 points.
So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They start on the ground here at Sanders, and he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. The numbers for Sanders last week, 18 carries, 123 yards, and a touchdown.
I think he's exactly where he wants to be coming into a game, partner, because he has to still be riding the momentum from last week when he broke the century mark in rushing and had one of his best individual efforts of the season. I would expect that there's more from him on the way after that type of a game, and I know his teammates and coaches, they feel exactly the same way.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now here's Young. Short throw underneath to Hurst. A solid stiff arm. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down. Looking to throw, Young. That is taken in by Hurst. He's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. A play fake. Now Young. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming. Young now. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. That also a career-long kick for the veteran. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys get your list done? Because I think every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
Second down and a little more than a yard here. Running right, here's Sanders. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Able to get the 1 yard he needed, but nothing more.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 3-0 after one on EA Sports.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. A give running left. It's Sanders. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Passing, it's Dalton. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And they'll get him to the ground, and he has another first down at the Colts 18. 19 yards the pickup there. Move the chains. They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, first and 10. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Dalton. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. Another good drive, Charles, but it looks like another that might end in a field goal try.
They've made some nice plays. They've given themselves opportunities, but as you noted, another field goal attempt coming up. And that's not how they want to end drives. They've got to figure out what's the final touch that they need to push it.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now, their 2 drives thus far both led to points, albeit both field goals, so the lead just 6-0, but the ability to move the ball is evident.
No, that's, you know, heartening, as they say, but it's not what they're about. What they're about is putting the ball in the end zone and putting sixes on the board. So if you're the offensive coordinator, you like what you're doing, but you don't love it. You've got to find a way to ring that bell. Then you can have a little self-satisfied grin. Right now, a little more determination is needed.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it 2nd and 6.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Meanwhile, Young's throw taken in by Chark. On 1st and 10, Young. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Jonathan Mingo, his 4th touchdown. Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. Following the interception, Young. To the right side and complete to Hurst. And he's got this down a yard or 2 shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. On 1st and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on 2nd and inches. Young working out of the gun. And that'll be incomplete.
So many things have to go right for any passing play to work out. Quarterback has to understand the defense, deliver an accurate ball. Receiver has to concentrate and bring it in. Somewhere along the assembly line, something was off with that one.
The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This is up and good from Pinheiro, and that will extend their lead even further. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little. So we are in the final minute now of the first half as this offense gets ready to take over. First and 10, Young. That's caught by Mingo, right side. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 53. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And that... on play action. Young. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. So a potential big play by this defense wiped out by the face mask.
And disappointing because it was so unnecessary. They had the sack. But the officials are definitely keeping a close eye on the quarterback, especially the referee. They were able to spot that one immediately.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. He'll be tackled shy of the 35. Shifty footwork gets him a little extra on the play. 55 yards rushing for him now to this point. Here now, second and 4. Young to throw it. He's got Mingo. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That one covers 29 yards. First down. Young off the play fake. To the right side and complete to Thomas. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now Young. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. From the shotgun, it's Young. Hard throw, incomplete. Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end is going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head because they understand how tight windows are there and how many bodies are there. And sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
So 3 more points tacked on, and this margin getting more. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
He's got his big tight end. That's Hurst. And he goes down at the 26. A pickup of 13, and that last play began at the 13. First down. Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. They go play action. Young. And that's going to be incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
And he'll make it only to the 43, a gain of 2. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Julian Blackmon. And the Colts will take. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. That's the tight end, Hurst, with it. Trucks over him. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before it's taken down. 39 yards there. Good one. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first. first and 10. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And he'll be taken down at about the 45. He was close to throwing to that sideline, but able to stay in bounds like you know his coach wants him to do and keep that clock moving.
Isn't it funny that we're watching this play when we had that discussion just yesterday about this? What do you do in this scenario? What do you, you know, what's your mindset? It appeared to me that he'd totally forgotten that he needed to stay in bounds. And then the last second, oh, no, I better get down. And he ended up doing the right thing. But at that point, maybe close to letting it slip away.
Young on third down. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need.
Picked off by Zaire Franklin. And the Colts are right back in this.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Big stop on the turnover on downs to get the football back, and now it's just all about salting this one away.
Yeah, just slowly bleed the clock away. Clock's definitely on your side. And, you know, when we talk about analytics in the game, what is this one? Advanced win metrics? Because if you take care of the football here, bleed the clock down, with about 95% chance of winning.
Oh, yeah, I'd say 95 or better. I know you always say it. Every coach does. It's just protecting the football at this point.
And knowing that the defensive guys, they're coming after the ball more than they are the person. They want to knock it free.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here.
Young is intercepted for the third time this game. Picked off by Zaire Franklin.
Then he will bring it back to about the 11-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all three timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he's able to get this across. So this one is over. A victory for Carolina.
It's week 9 of the NFL, and we'll see Tony Pollard. He had a great week last week, well over 100 on the ground with a score. It's the Cowboys and the Eagles on EA Sports.
We're just a stone's throw from the Delaware River, and we've got some water to contend with ourselves. A steady rain falling at Lincoln Financial Field.
Today, it's a week 9 matchup. We're all set to go, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Philadelphia Eagles.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They come in on a pretty good roll here, winners of three straight.
And they looked awfully good last week and came away with a two-touchdown victory. They did have a few reasons for concern.
Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field.
On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive.
And that one goes for about six as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
Well, this defense for the Cowboys, they were terrific last week in the win over the Rams.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
7 yards there and a first down.
Once again, it's Swift. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
A big pickup there for the Eagles' first down, 18 yards.
Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's Hurts to throw.
Touchdown, Eagles!
Devontae Smith
with touchdown number 7 on the year. After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. They'll start on the ground. It's Rashad Penny. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him.
They go play action with Hurts.
And he's going to hook up with his big tight end. Complete.
That's on Pro Bowl center Jason Kelce. They will run straight ahead with Swift.
And he'll be taken down at the 18.
Now, whistles and a stoppage here. Looks like one of the Eagles is in some discomfort out there. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. Hurts.
He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.